But when they heard Mitch turned up his nose, calling him mad, a frenzy smit him man and then again did no a sound distrain, o man exceeding wretched, base in heart, unstable, living modesty bane and loving shamelessness, rapacious lords, fierce sinners, false, insatiate, mischievous, in nothing true, stealthy adulterers, flippant in language, pouring forth foul words, the wrath of God most I not fearing, kept to the fifth generation to Atone. In no way do ye wail, harsh men, but laugh, sardonic smile uno shall ye laugh, when shall come that which speak godesse dire in coming flood, when ever esse polluted race, in the great earth blooming perennial in impervious stem, shall, root and branch, in one night disappear, and cities, men and all, shall the earth shaker from the depth scatter and their walls destroy. And then the whole world of unnumbered men shall die. But how shall uno weep, how lament in wooden house, how mingle tears with waves? For, if this water bidden of God shall come, earth shall float, hills float, and even sky shall float, everything shall be water, and all things shall be destroyed by waters. And the winds shall stand still, and a second age shall come. O Phrygia, do shalt from the water esse crest first rise up, and do first another race of men shalt nourish, once again a new beginning, and do shalt be nurse for all. But when now to the lawless generation he had thus vainly spoken, the most I appeared, and once more cried aloud and said, the time is now come, Noah, to proclaim each thing, even all which that day to thee did promise and confirm, and to complete, because of a people disobedient, through out the boundless world even all the things which generations of a former time did practice, evil things innumerable.
But thou do quickly enter with thy sons and the wives, call as many as I bid, of tribes of beasts and creeping things and birds, and in as many as I ordain for life will I then put a willingness to go. Thus spoke he, forth went Noah and aloud cried out and called. And then wife, sons and brides, entered the house of wood, then also went the other things, as many as God willed to shut in. But when fitting bolt was put about the lid, and in its polished place was fitted sideways, then was brought to pass forth with the purpose of the God of heaven. And he massed clouds, and be did the sun esse bright disk, and moon, and stars, and circle of the heaven, obscuring all things round, he thundered loud, terror of mortals, sending lightnings forth, and all the winds together were aroused, and all the veins of water were unloosed by opening of great cataracts from heaven, and from earth esse caverns and the tireless deep appeared the myriad waters, and the whole illimitable earth was covered over. But on the water swam that wondrous house, and torn by many furious waves, and struck by force of winds, it rushed on fearfully, but with its keel it cut the mass of foam while the loud babbling waters dashed around. But when God deluged all the world with rains, then also Noah took thought to observe by counsels of the immortal, for he now aided Noah of Nereus. And straightway the house he opened from the polished wall, that crosswise was bound fast with skillful stays. And looking out upon the mighty mass of boundless waters, Noah on all sides and to us his fortune with his eyes to see. Fear possessed and shook mightily his heart. And then there became a little calm, since it was very wet in all the world many days. Parting, then, it brought to light how pale and blood red was the mighty sky and sun esse bright disk awarded. Scarcely held Noah his courage, and then forth afar sent he a dove alone, that he might learn if yet firm land appeared. But with tired wing, flying round all things, she again returned, for not yet had the water ebbed away, for it was deeply filling every place.